Looking past the pretty wrapper. Let's be honest, there simply aren't a huge amount of new vehicles out there that are simply so attractive that they can influence developed reasonable grown-ups to do moronic things, for example, burning through $51.90 substantial on a SUV that can be had for thousands less at the Jag store, wearing nearly as bringing a wrapper. Nearly. As one of those reasonable people whose knees go absolutely wiggly for the inside and outside styling of the Land Rover Range Rover Velar, I try to give an open administration here to my kindred right masterminds by introducing 11 obstinate goal pluses and minuses, shocks and joys with which your left cerebrum can help talk your correct mind into or out of the dazzling new Velar. The mechanical architect in me worries about mechanizing things that are considerably more effectively left mechanical. Of course, air flushness is useful for fuel utilization, yet it can without much of a stretch be proficient the way Sister Mark Jag does it: press the forward edge of a flush entryway handle, and the back flies out. The Velar's handles engine out when the auto is opened, by means of coxcomb or a press of the catch on any handle, and they just withdraw when you relock the auto. However, at any rate not at all like the electric discharge locks on a Tesla Model S, the scent Velar handles are mechanically associated with the hooks. What's more, covered up inside the key dandy is a thin key that can physically open a Velar with a dead battery. Pretty cool. Every Velar accompanies not one but rather two free duplicates of the motion drawing delineation that was so loyally conveyed to generation as the Range Rover Velar. Simply approach or leave the auto during the evening, and puddle lights venture these illustrations down from each rearview reflect. Very cool. Illuminated ledge plates are currently being offered on autos valued here and there the status stepping stool, however open a front entryway. And notwithstanding the illuminated R-dynamic ledge plate, under-dash footwell lighting appears to spotlight the metal Velar nameplate on the floor dangle. Furthermore, significantly less expected among wagons and utes in any class is a lit-up load zone ledge plate. Pleasantly played. When stopped and bolted, the guiding wheel catches, instrument bunch, and focal show screens and handles are largely dark and featureless. Move on board with the key in your pocket, and the IP screen broadcasts your shrewd decision of moving up to the R-dynamic execution demonstrate with a similar logo you ventured over on the ledge plate while the upper focus show screen demonstrates the green oval Land Rover symbol. The lower screen and the surrounding lighting both shine, also. Simply after you switch the vehicle on do the directing wheel control capacities, checks, and screen menus wake up. Extremely emotional. A couple of nits to pick, this prepared menu prober was not able find the controls for modifying the shade of the surrounding lighting. I later learned of a helpful online proprietor's manual that taught me, from the home screen, swipe the touchscreen to one side to get to the extra features screen. See touchscreen home menu. Choice 11 is surrounding lighting. I found the choices for changing the upper focus show's screen saver picture, the favored blower fan attitude, delicate and calm, adjusted for comfort, effective and quick, and for picking the lower screen's default show, be that as it may. I never found an approach to handicap the programmed sunroof shade, which opened upon each startup and shut upon each shutdown, stressing me over its longevity. Objects behind are farther than they appear. Since rearview cameras are being ordered as standard hardware on everything, the favor autos are attempting to separate themselves with bird's eye see pictures and trickier wide point cameras, for example, the Velars. This is awesome for seeing cross activity, yet it influenced it to seem as though I was going to touch the edge of the carport entryway each time. One of the things everybody cherishes about the Velars inside is its smooth look. Uncluttered by a squillion catches controlling the same number of capacities. A major empowering agent of this look is the multifunction bring-down screen with its two revolving handles, the elements of which can differ contingent upon which screen is dynamic. They for the most part control left and right temperature, yet squeeze them, and they'll change the driver and traveler situate warming or cooling capacities. Call up the vehicle screen, and the left one chooses among the numerous dynamic and rough terrain driving modes. There are likely more assignments they play out that I never experienced in an insignificant week with the Velar. Anticipate that this thought will multiply quickly. There is a little jewel catch on the guiding wheel that can be doled out not one but rather two as often as possible utilized capacities. Choices incorporate scratch-off nav direction, next sound source, sound quiet, sound play, stop, get to telephone voice message, amplifier quiet, phone hold, auto dismiss a call, upper screen off, and movement cautions. Press the catch rapidly for one capacity, squeeze it for longer to get to the second capacity. What number of people will find and utilize the second option? Loads of favor extravagance autos offer back rub seating. Nothing bums me out more regrettable when driving one than when I end up toward the finish of an adventure in the wake of having neglected to switch the condemned thing on. Land Rover has tackled this issue by enabling me to program the seats to consequently begin needing my back 5, 10, 15, 30, or an hour into an excursion. Normally I pick the 5-minute setting. I am not mindful of another producer offering this glimmer of brilliance. As much as I cherish the auto-rub situate choice, I abhor having to physically abbreviate the accompanying separation from the default most extreme after separation to the nearest after each start cycle. In some other setting, each other driver out and about will fill the liberal hole in front of the Velar, impeding its encouraging on a bustling interstate. Machine learning will soon enable autos to deduce our inclinations, explaining issues, for example, this, ideally without transforming the majority of our autos into murderous HAL 9000s. The lighting supply world is truly exceeding itself nowadays with natural LEDs, favor light pipes, diffusing focal points, virtual reflectors and so forth. The Velar's tail lamps most likely join a few of these new advances to make additional profound-looking LED tail lamps. Any adroit fashioner puts a spoiler or something to that effect on the back of a two-box wagon or UTA to urge the air to isolate neatly as opposed to sticking to the back window and sucking the auto in reverse. Maybe a couple of them put little vents like the two splendid openings you can find in this one. They're there to enable a touch of air to brush earth and fog off the back window. It may well cost a small amount of a drag coefficient point, yet the investment funds in raised window washer liquid may well be justified regardless of the trade-off.